Welcome you all, myself Professor Shilpa Rao. Today we are going to see the topic gas laws and ideal gas equation. First of all, we'll see general properties of gases. Gases do not have a definite shape and volume. Gases occupy a whole space available to them. Meaning of this sentence, suppose you have a 10 liter container with you and 1 liter gas with you, then whole 10 liter space of your container occupied by your 1 liter gas. Gases have an unlimited dispensability and high compressibility. They have a very low densities because of negligible intermolecular forces. That's why they are less dense. Then gases exert a pressure on the wall of your container, have a perfectly elastic polyvalence. They diffuse rapidly through each other from homogeneous mixture against electric and gravitational field. A gas molecules is having very good diffusibility, means it can be easily diffused with one another. And two types of the gases can be easily diffused into one another as compared to the other states of your matter. Now, properties of gases. Gas law are generalization that describe mathematically the relationship between the four properties. Okay, means different gas laws will give you idea what exactly the relationship between these four parameters. Which are those four parameters? First is pressure, second is volume, third is temperature, and last is the amount of gas in mole. Now, a gas exerts a pressure as its molecule collides with the surface of your container that holds it, and the pressure is results of the collisions divided by unit area receiving the force, and this force pressure will become force upon area. And the atmosphere exerts a pressure on the earth by the collision of molecule with every surface it contacts. That's why there is a formation of atmospheric pressure. Same is the concept, that is force divided by area. Then volume. The volume of gas depend upon the pressure of your gas, then temperature of your gas, and number of mole of your gas. So the volume of gas is expressed in ml or liter. Then next parameter, that is temperature. Temperature is defined as degrees of hotness. Then SI unit for the temperature is Kelvin, and degree centigrade and degree Fahrenheit are two other units used for measuring the temperature. On the Celsius scale, water freezes at 0 degree centigrade and boils at the 100 degree centigrade. Whereas in Kelvin scale, water freezes at the 273 Kelvin and boils at 373 Kelvin. Now, if you see the relationship between Kelvin and degree centigrade, then 1 Kelvin is equal to degree centigrade plus 273.5. Then correlationship between your Fahrenheit and degree Celsius is 1 Fahrenheit is equal to 9/5 degree centigrade plus 32. The temperature of gas is related to kinetic energy of molecules. Kinetic energy means movement or the motion of your molecules, gas molecules. That is kinetic energy. The velocity of gas particle increases as temperature increases. means what happen as the temperature of your system goes on increasing, kinetic energy is also increases, and this kinetic energy is responsible to increase the velocity of your molecules, means they try to travel more path if you have a higher temperature. The amount of gas, that is number of moles, gases are usually measured in grams, and gas laws calculation require that quantity of your gas is expressed in moles. Then moles of gas represent number of particle of gas that are present when working gas law problem, then convert the mass in gram to moles. Means for the calculation point of view, for the easy calculation, we are converting these grams of your gas into the moles. Gas pressure, use a device called barometer, measures height of mercury in glass tube, invented in 1643 by Torricelli scientist, and units are of mm of units are in mm of Hg. Then common units used for the measuring the or used to measure the gas pressure, that is mm of Hg or torque. 1 mm of Hg is equal to 1 torque. Then atmospheric pressure, 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 760 torque. Then another unit is Pascal, 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 101325 Pascal. Then gas pressure is measured with the help of barometer. It consists of height of column of mercury and the pressure of the atmosphere support the column of mercury, and the length of mercury in the column is measure of your pressure. Means as height of your mercury goes on increasing, it will give you idea pressure is high. At a sea level, the mercury would be 760 mm of Hg above the surface of the table. Units of pressures, the pressure of gas is expressed in atmospheric pressure, then Pascal, bars. 760 mm is equal to 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 101.5 kilopascal. Then pressure of your gas depends on collision of the gas molecule with wall of the container and number of collisions, average force of collisions, and all these things responsible to create the pressure into the container. Pressure and volume relationship described by the scientist Boyle's. If pressure on the gas increases, then volume decreases proportionally. As long as temperature and n, means number of moles, are constant, as volume decreases, more collisions with the wall occurs, and so pressure increases, because your gas will get less surface to move, and it start to collides with each other, and it increases the pressure. Now we'll see gas laws one by one. First, Boyle's law. In 1662, Robert Boyle discovered that there existed a relationship between the pressure and volume of fixed amount of gas at a fixed temperature. Fixed amount of gas means you have to keep number of mole of your gas constant, and second thing you have to keep constant, that is temperature. In his experiment, he discovered that the product of pressure and volume of fixed amount of gas at fixed temperature was approximately constant. So, Boyle's law states that at a constant temperature and pressure of fixed amount of gas, that is number of mole of your gas should be constant, and the pressure of this fixed amount of gas varies inversely with its volume. Means as pressure increases, your volume decreases. If you see this diagram, what happened? This is your piston. As this piston moves ahead, your gas molecule will get less space and immediately it start to increase the pressure. Initially, your pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure, and as you are moving the piston to downward, what happen? These arrow or these pressure, this screen will show you how pressure goes on increasing. Okay, means the product of your pressure and volume is equal to C, that is constant, where temperature is constant and your number of moles of gas are constant. Now if you see the volume versus pressure, this is your volume and you are increasing the pressure, means you are moving from this left side to right side, then ultimately your volume goes on decreasing. Initially it was 4 and after applying the pressure it will become 2. Mathematically, it means that at a constant temperature, product of your pressure and volume of fixed amount of gas is constant. If fixed amount of gas at a constant temperature occupying volume V and pressure P1 and undergo the expansion, so that volume become V2 and pressure will become P2, then according to Boyle's law, P is inversely proportional to V, then P is equal to K1 into 1 upon V. K is the proportionality constant and product of this P and V is equal to K1, that is constant. Then second case, initially your pressure and volume was P1 and V1 and then it moved towards the P2 and V2, then it will become constant because product of your pressure volume at initial time and after time t, it will be constant. Then graphical representation of your Boyle's law. When you plot the graph P versus 1 by V at fixed temperature and fixed mass of your gas, then it passes through the origin, because as we all know, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. For that purpose, graph for this statement will be straight line. Then in second case, a pressure versus volume. Okay, all of you know pressure is inversely proportional to volume and directly proportional to 1 upon volume. That's why the graph is straight line, and graph of your pressure versus volume is showing you down curve or this is the initial high pressure. At that time your volume is less. If you see the correlation, initially it was less. Okay, as you are increasing the pressure, then volume will become less. Now second gas law, that is Charles law. In 1787, Jacques Charles discovered that the pressure is kept constant and volume of your gas sample increases linearly with temperature for fixed amount of gas. This law lead to the idea of temperature, the unit of temperature used in Kelvin, and the statement of law is at a constant pressure, volume of your given mass of gas is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Means as temperature goes on increasing, volume of your gas increases because it starts to expand and it occupies more space as it increases the temperature. If you see this diagram, you have a balloon with you and you some gas molecules, fixed amount of gas molecules, and you start to give the heat to this balloon. Then immediately these molecules within the balloon start to expand and increase the size of your balloon. Means increasing the size of your balloon means increasing volume of your gas. Okay, means as we are increasing the temperature, volume goes on increasing. Mathematically, we can write volume is directly proportional to the temperature. That's why your V upon T will become constant. But when your pressure, volume of gas V at a temperature T and change to V1 and at a T2, then your equation will become, means if initially it is having a volume V1 and T1, and after giving some heat or increasing the temperature, it will become V2 and T2. Then your equation will become V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2 is equal to constant. Now graphical representation of Charles' law. For a definite mass of gas, plot volume versus temperature at constant pressure and a fixed volume of gas when it passing through the origin, because volume is directly proportional to the temperature. That's why your graph will become straight line. If you vary the temperature, then you will get these different lines. Then we'll move towards the Avogadro's law. If you have a balloon with you containing a mass of gas, if we add to more mass of gas holding temperature and the pressure, the constant volume of gas will increase. And it was experimentally shows that the amount of gas in moles is proportional to the volume. That is, volume is directly proportional to the number of moles. When temperature and pressure is constant, then your V is equal to AN. A is the proportionality constant, and your final equation will become, after moving this A to the left hand side, V upon A is equal to N. Suppose your molecules is having the initial volume V1. And after time t, it will be V2, and respective number of moles will be N1 and N2 at constant temperature and pressure. Then your equation will become V1 upon V2 is equal to A is equal to N1 upon N2. This is basic for the Avogadro's law, which may be stated as equal volume of gases at the same temperature and pressure contain equal number of moles or molecules. If molar amount is doubled, then volume is also double. Okay, suppose you have 1 mole of gas with you initially, then its volume will be 22.4 liter. Okay, when you increase the number of moles, when you add one more mole, then it will become 2 mole and volume will become exactly double of your previous volume. This is the Avogadro's law. Now, if you see this diagram carefully, as we are increasing the volume, as we are increasing the number of moles, it increases the volume because its this piston starts to move back side. It requires more space to occupy this increased volume of your gas. That's why V1 upon N1 will become V2 upon N2. Then molar gas volume, it follows as a corollary of Avogadro's law, that 1 mole of your gas at a constant temperature and pressure has the same fixed volume. It is called molar gas volume or molar volume. In order to compare the molar volume of gas, chemist uses fixed reference temperature and pressure. And that fixed temperature and pressure is 273 Kelvin, that is 0 degree centigrade, is considered as the standard temperature, while 1 atmospheric pressure considered as the standard pressure. Then at a standard temperature and pressure, we find experimentally that 1 mole of gas occupies 22.4 liter volume. To put it in the form of equation, then we have 1 mole of gas at a standard temperature and pressure is equal to 22.4 liters. Then by combining this Boyle's law, as we all know, as per Boyle's law, volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Then as per Charles' law, volume is directly proportional to the temperature. Then as per Avogadro's law, volume is directly proportional to the number of moles. Then your final equation will become V is directly proportional to, if you took this V, is directly proportional to temperature, directly proportional to the number of moles, and inversely proportional to the pressure. Then V into constant, that constant is R. Then by rearranging, you will get the final equation. PV is equal to nRT. Okay, N, R is the constant, N is the number of mole, T is the temperature, P is the pressure, and V is the volume. Now see this diagram. As pressure increases, volume goes on decreasing. Okay, as pressure increases, temperature is also increases. Both are proportional to each other. Then as pressure increases, temperature is also goes on increasing. This is the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. Then universal gas constant, as we all know, 0 degree centigrade and 1 atmospheric pressure is considered as the standard temperature and pressure. Then we can determine the unit of this R. Okay, our equation is PV is equal to nRT. By rearranging, it will become R is equal to PV upon NT. Then P is the pressure, 1 atmospheric pressure. All of you know at STP,
volume is 22.414 liter, then volume is 1 mole and temperature is 273.15 Kelvin. Now unit of your R will become liter atmospheric pressure divided by mole into Kelvin. This is all about the ideal gas equation and gas laws. Thank you.